Good morning and welcome to the online lecture for this elective 4, that is solar and wind energy. We are starting here the unit number 2, and we have just started the introduction of this unit in the last lecture, and we will discuss now in details. So the topics included in this unit number 2 is the types of the solar thermal collector, and all the questions are theoretical based on the types of these collectors only. Okay. So we will discuss one by one what are the different types of the solar collector here, and today we will see the liquid flat plate collector and its analysis. Okay, so we'll complete this part up to this part, and then later on we'll discuss the another part. So here this is its design and application, solar air heater and heat types. Okay, so so we'll concentrate main first of all this one, the classification and the flat type collector analysis. Okay. So these things we will cover in today's lecture. Okay, so types of the solar thermal collector. So this is our today's topic. Okay, so first of all, what is meant by the solar collector? Okay, so solar collector is solar power, that means the solar radiation which are coming from the sun, it is having very low density per unit area. Okay, and because of that we more that is the coverage area, or we require more covering area to trap the solar radiation. Okay, because of the low density per unit area of this solar power. So for that purpose we require the solar thermal collectors. Okay, that's why the surface area of these collectors are very large. Okay, because we have to trap that maximum amount of the solar energy, and its density is very low. Okay, so that's why we require here more the ground area or the collector area. So that for that purpose we are going for the solar thermal collectors. Now the major components of any solar system, it is the solar collector. So that is there only. Okay, now what is the main function of this device? So this device absorbs the incoming solar radiation, okay, and converts it into heat. Okay, then after converting that into heat, then it transfers that heat to the fluid which is flowing through the collector. Okay, so this is the main function of the solar collector. So it absorbs the first of all it absorbs the incoming solar radiation, then it transfers that, it converts that heat into the heat, the solar radiation, it is converted into the thermal energy, and then that thermal energy or heat, it is transferred to the fluid which is flowing through the collector. So that is the main function of the solar collector. Okay, now the energy that is collected, or the solar energy that is collected, that is given to the fluid. Okay, so what we have done, first of all we have absorbed the solar radiation, we have converted that into heat, and then we have transferred that heat to the fluid which is flowing through the collector. So this is the fluid which is flowing through the collector. So we have given this heat to this fluid. Okay, now this fluid which is carrying this heat, now this fluid transfer this heat to the another source. Okay, so that may be then afterward use for the purpose like boiler, heat exchanger, or it may be used for the thermal energy storage tank. Okay, or it may be stored in the thermal energy storage tank. Okay, so this is the total sequence of how the solar energy get trapped into the solar thermal collectors, and then it is used for the final purpose. Okay, so first of all it is converted into the heat, solar radiations are converted into the heat into the solar collector, then it is transferred to the fluid which is flowing through the collector, and then after absorbing the heat this fluid, then this heat is used for various purposes like the heat in exchanger, in boiler, or in the storage tank. Okay, so that is our the basic understanding of the solar collectors. Okay. Now let us see what are the different types of the collectors are there. So there are two types of the thermal collectors are there. One is called as the non-concentrating, and the another one is the concentrating. Okay, now let us discuss about the non-concentrating and the concentrating type. Okay, so we know that in non-concentrating collectors, now this is aperture area. Now what is meant by this aperture area? Now aperture area means what? The area that receives the solar radiation, that means the total area that receives the radiation. So suppose if this is the our solar collector, then we'll consider this as the aperture area, because this is the maximum area that is in contact or that is that is in contact, or we will say that is approaching the solar radiations. Okay, so total area. Okay, so this is the total area. We consider this as the aperture area. Okay, now it is roughly the same area as the absorber area. Okay, now inside this we have the absorber plate. So this is this black color. This is showing the absorber plate. Okay, so that is our absorber. Okay, so what is this in non-concentrating collectors? It is what is happening. The aperture area is roughly the same as the absorber area. Okay, so that means this area and the bottom side area, so both are same. Okay, so this is our aperture area AP. Suppose we consider this as AP, and inside we have the absorber area because of the absorber plate. So in case of the non-concentrating collector, so these are both the areas are it is approximately same. Okay, now we'll take the common example of this system is the okay. So here it is, one example is given. Suppose we can consider metal plate here. Suppose this plate, and we are okay. Now the solar radiation is incident on this temperature of this increase. It's in some water, suppose. Okay, then it is its heat. Okay, so that is the same principle that we are using in this solar collector. So we first heat some particular liquid that is through the flowing through this the pipes which are used in the solar collectors, and then once that fluid absorbs the heat from the solar radiation, so that heat again get transferred to the another fluid. Okay, so that is the sequence of the transfer of the heat in the solar collectors. So in non-concentrating collector, the aperture area, so AP, and the absorber area, that is same. Okay, so that is the main thing we have to remember here. Now in concentrating collectors, what will happen? So we have much aperture area than the absorber area. So here this AP, so this is AP is much greater than that of the absorber area. So it is A absorber area. Okay, so this is the, now if you consider this one, so this is our the concentrating collector. Okay, so in this case, if you see the aperture area is larger than that of the absorber area. So here we have the black color, that is the AB is here in, and the outer area that represents about the aperture area. Okay, so more area is in contact with the solar radiation than the absorber surface. Okay, so that's why it is called the concentrating collector. Okay, now here it is, the aperture is mainly in the form of the mirror. Okay, and that is focused on the absorber, and then afterwards all these things are absorbed. So here, see, this is our aperture area. So this is our aperture area that is in the form of the mirrors, and this part, okay, this part is only our absorber area. So this is our absorber area. Suppose it is AB. Okay, so this part represent the absorber, and this part represent what, the aperture area. So all these are the mirrors. Solar radiation, solar rays will incident on this collector, and then it is get reflected on the absorber surface. So like this, reflected. So this is our absorber area, this is our aperture area. That's why it is said that in concentrating collectors, the AP is greater than that of the AB. Okay, so the nomenclature we have decided. So this is AP greater than, suppose this. So that is mentioned here only. Okay, so which is in most of the cases are the pipes carrying the working plate. So here this is our absorber surface. Okay, now also another thing is what, due to the movement of the sun during the day, okay, the concentrating collectors often require some of the rotation. We call that as a rotation as a solar tracking. Okay, we call that as a solar tracking. Okay, that means in case of the concentrating non-concentrating collector, we can't move these systems in the direction of the sun during the daytime. Okay, during the whole daytime, it is, that means once it is fixed. So this is the tilt angle. So this is our beta angle. Now this angle is very important, beta or alpha or the phi, that is the inclination angle. So once the non-concentrating type of collector, like so, that is the heater or the liquid flat collector, once they are fixed, so we can't change the direction of this collector. Okay, but in case of the concentrating collector, we can put the solar tracking system here, and we can move this total collector. Okay, so we have seen that one, in 1 hour it takes how much degree. So this is, it takes 115 degree. Okay, it takes 115 degree. So in every hour we have to move this in 15 degree. Okay, so in the direction of the travel of the sun. Okay, so that movement of this total the collector, so we call that as a solar tracking. Okay, and solar tracking, it is also referred as the active collectors. Okay, so that we have to understand here. So let me see who is there. So this is our the second type of the collector, that is called as the concentrating collectors. Okay, so concentrating, first of all, two things we have to remember. One is the aperture area. So this is our aperture area, AP. That means the area which is in contact with solar radiation. So we are discussing about the two things, that is the concentrating collector. So we have one aperture area is more as compared to the absorber area. So this is our absorber plate here, which is in the form of the pipe, and the liquid is flowing through this pipe. Okay, and this is our the collector. So that is in the form of the mirrors. Okay, so that we have discussed. Okay, now what are the applications of these two types of the collector? So what we are discussing, the concentrating collectors and the non-concentrating collectors. Okay. So we have discussed, in non-concentrating collectors, this aperture area is same as that of the absorber area. So this is our aperture area, and at the bottom we have the absorber area. So aperture area means what? The area which is directly in contact with the solar radiation. So that is called as the aperture area. Okay. So the solar radiation is here, and this area is in direct contact with the solar radiation. And then below that we have put the absorber surface. So that is having the area of the absorber surface. Okay, so we have taken that is our non-concentrating collectors. Okay, and in case of the non-concentrating collector, we can't move this collector. Okay, it is a fixed one. Once you fix this system, so it is fixed. Okay, once you put some angles here, so if this is the tilt angle or inclination angle, so, and it is placed always toward in south direction. Okay, it is toward the south direction. Okay, now in concentrating collector we have seen it is the this aperture area. So aperture area means the area which is in front of the solar radiation. So that is our aperture area, and the absorber area is this one. So this is very small. Okay, but the most important the point of this the concentrating collector is what? It is it tracks the sun during its operation. Okay, so we have seen that is in 1 hour the total the sun it travels the 50 it travels the 15 degree. So whenever to track this concentrating collectors, we have to tilt in 15 degree for each 1 hour. So we call this as the movement of this collector as a we call this as a solar tracking system. Okay, it is solar tracking system. We can do it manually also, but nowadays we can electronically operate this system. Okay, so that is called as the solar tracking systems. Okay, now what are the applications of this one? Now non-concentrating collectors are used in the residential and in commercial building for space heating. So these are used for the solar air heater, then for drying of the agricultural products, then it is used for solar air heater. So this is your solar air heater, solar water heater. So these are used for the commercial purposes for the residential and the commercial building. While concentrated, they are used for the power plant for generation of the electricity. Okay, and by heating the heater, the heat transfer fluid to run the turbine. So this is used for what? Generation of the power. So the electricity is generated mainly using the concentrating collector, and also the temperature range of this concentrating collector is higher than that of the these non-concentrating collectors. Okay, so these two types of the solar thermal collectors you have to remember: non-concentrating and concentrating. And just remember these two points in terms of the area. Okay. And the another one is in terms of the applications. Okay, or and the solar tracking system. Okay, Now let us come to the next point. Now the solar, we will see the classification of the solar collectors. Okay, so solar collectors, these are broadly classified into the two types we have already seen, that is non-concentrating and the concentrating type. Okay, now in non-concentrating type, the examples are the flat plate collectors. So we will discuss this one in today's lecture, two types, that is the liquid flat collectors and flat plate air collector. Then afterwards we will discuss the concentrating type. In concentrating type, we have two types. One is the focus type and another one is called the non-focus type. Okay, then in focus type, we have again two type. One is called the line focus and another is called the point focus. Okay, so line focus means it is one, suppose it is one pipe and total radiations are concentrated on this pipe. So that is our line pipe. And point focus means it is all the total radiations are concentrated and at some point. Okay, so that is our line, that is our point focus. Okay, so line focus and the point focus, these are the two types of the classification in focus type. And in focus type means what it is just the modifications of this non-concentrating type. That is, what are the disadvantages are there in non-concentrating type collector. So they are taken into consideration and some modification is done in this type of the collector. And so this is modified flat plate collector, and the another one is the compound parabolic concentrating type collector. Okay, so these are the types of the collectors that we have to discuss in the coming lectures. Okay, so today we will concentrate on this type. Okay, that is non-concentrating type. We will discuss the liquid flat plate collector and flat, that is air heating system, that is air, that is solar air heater. Okay, so this is flat plate air heating collector. So before going to the actual collector, now there are some performance indices the basis of which we can decide we can purchase this type of the collector. So one is the collector efficiency. Okay, so first of all you have to check what is the collector efficiency of that collector, what is the concentration ratio and what is the temperature range. Okay, now collector efficiency is the ratio of energy absorbed and transferred to the heat transporting fluid by the collector. Okay, to the energy incident on the collector. Okay, that means how much energy it is incident on the solar collector, and out of that how much energy, this is the total energy incident on the solar collector, and how much is take the ratio of and to the, that is E. Out of the total energy, this much of energy we have used or we have transferred fluid which is flowing through the collector, and we have the how much the total amount of energy incident on the collector. So that is our ET, suppose. So this, if you calculate this total ratio, so we'll get the efficiency of the collector. Okay, so this is very important factor, so that we have to consider while purchasing or while designing any collector. Okay, or we'll see in this direction. Suppose we have to design the collector, so how we have to consider these two factors. Okay, so total incident radiation, and out of that how much the useful energy that is absorbed by the fluid which is flowing through the collector. Now concentration ratio, second one, that is the CR. Now it is defined as what? The area of the aperture of the system to the area of the receiver. Okay, area of the aperture of the system. So we all seen that is the aperture area. So aperture is what? The projected area of the collector facing normal to the beam. So already we have seen. So this is the, suppose if this is the non-concentrated type collector like this. So this is the solar radiation. This is normal, suppose. And then this is our aperture area. This is our aperture area. To the area of the receiver. Okay, area total to the area of the receiver. Receiver means what? The receiver means how much the total remaining area. Okay, that means the useful area upon the total area available. Okay, we'll define this concept ratio something like this. That means we are the, suppose the area something like this. Out of this, how much area it is useful for absorbing the solar radiation. So that we consider as a concentration ratio. Okay, so aperture area means that is the area at which the useful radiations are incident and get absorbed to the whatever the area which is available. Okay, So this is called as our concentration ratio. Now, because of that, the by trapping this solar energy, the temperature of this fluid will increase. That is, the heat transfer fluid will increase. So that is that will define our third parameter, that is temperature range. So it is the range of temperature to which the heat transfer fluid is heated by the collector. So this is again very important, the parameter. I have already told you, in non-concentrated type, the temperature, this temperature range is low. While if you require more temperature range, then we have to go for the concentrating type of the collector. So this is for concentrating and non-concentrating type collector. So these are the three performance indices we have to consider while designing or while purchasing these collectors. So one is the collector efficiency, second one is the concentration ratio, okay, and this temperature range, okay, this temperature range. Now start with the first type of the collector. So that is our liquid flat plate collector, okay. Now here, if you see the diagram for this solar flat collector, it is easy to understand. So we will start with the first thing. So that is the transparent cover. Okay. So the transparent cover that is given here. So that is glass cover is our transparent cover. So transparent cover, it is one or two sheets of the glass or plastic. Maximum in time, we are using the glass only. So that is our the transparent cover, which is placed at the top. So this is our the glass cover. Okay. After that, we have the absorber plate. So this part, so here this is this red line whatever I have drawn. So that is our blackened absorber plate, and this is made up usually of the copper, aluminium, or the steel. Okay, this is made up of aluminium or the steel. Okay, copper is the best choice for all types of the absorber plate. Okay, then the absorber plate is over. After that, we have the tubes, channels, or the passages. So this one, this is showing this one. This is showing these are our tubes, channels, or the passages, and through these tubes. So these are the tubes there in front of you. You are so through these passages, we are the water and oil are the water is flowing through these tubes. These are the tubes which are placed below this absorber. There are again the several arrangement through which we can place these tubes. Okay, so that is there. So these are the tubes, and last thing is the weather tight insulated container. Okay, so all this system we have to insulate it. So okay, so we have to insulate all this system. So for that purpose, we have to use the insulated container. Okay, so it is something like this. Okay. So if you draw this in 3D, something like this, so it is somewhat like a rectangular box, okay, like this. Okay, this is insulated box, something like this. If you draw this in a 3D, so it comes something like this. Okay, after this is the topmost cover. So this is over the transparent cover. This is made up of the glass. Okay, we'll see that is in detail also. So this is our glass. You can put it one layer also, or one or two layer. So up to two layer it is sufficient. So glass cover, it is sufficient. Then after that, we have blackened surface. So at the bottom here, we paint this as a black. Okay, so this is our blackened surface. Okay, or some distance above here in the middle. Okay, in the middle support here. So this is our blackened surface. Then after that, we have the tubes. So tubes you can place here on the bottom side of this absorber plate. So here these are the tubes. So these are the tubes here. So these are the tubes below this absorber plate. So this is our absorber plate, and this is our the tubes. And then all these things, it is weather tight. That means you have to apply insulation. Okay. So that is there. Okay. So this is given here. So here you see, this is the solar radiation. It is coming in the form of both, that is direct and diffuse radiation. Okay. Then it is incident on the glass cover, and then it is coming inside. We'll see details in that one. Then after that, we have done two types of the things. That is the one, the headers are also there. Okay. So header pipes, they take the fluid in one the fluid through the head. This one. User Also, what absorber plate being black, it absorbs the radiation and its temperature increases. Okay, now the let me see who is there. Okay, so then okay, so solar radiation strikes. So these are okay. Now thickness of the absorber plate is in the range of 0.2 to 0.1 mm. So all these points you have to consider while designing this solar plate, that is the liquid tank plate. So we have that in the third unit, we have to design the solar water heater. So while designing this, this is similar to the your solar water design. Okay, so we have to consider these are the points. So absorber plate is in the range of 0.2 to 0.2 to 1 mm only. Okay, so absorber plate thickness. Now the next thing is what, the heat is transferred to the heat transfer circulating fluid beneath the absorber. So already I have told you that is the this is your absorber plate, and the tubes or the passages, they are placed below this absorber plate. Okay, so this is your absorber plate, and the tubes are placed here, beneath the absorber plate. Okay, so this is one type of the arrangement. I will show you the another types of arrangement also. Okay, now the metallic tube range. Okay, now this the diameter of these tubes, whatever the tubes which are we are taking, so this comes in the range of 1 to 1.5 centimeter. Okay, so we have given the diameter for these tubes also, and we have given the thickness of this absorber plate also. Okay, these are the standard things which are taken from the ASME standard book. Okay, we can't take this as an approximate. Okay, these are given in ASME standard book. Then we have to refer the standards, ASME standard, and then we have to design this liquid flat plate collector. Okay, so we have to refer the standard, ASME standard. So all these things are taken from the ASME standard book or the reference. Okay, so that is, this reference is taken for this one. So thickness is in the range of 0.2 to 1 mm. This is your MCQ question. They will ask in the examination, and metallic tube in the diameter of ASME from 1 to 1.5 centimeter. Okay. Now these tubes, how will connect this tube with the absorber plate? So this may be up, by means of the welding, or we can solder it. Okay, or we can apply the pressure bonded. Okay, we can apply the pressure bond, and we can fix it here. Okay, so soldered or brazed or welded or pressure bonded. Okay, we can place this the tubes beneath the absorber plate. Now we required some the speech. That means this is our absorber plate. This is one tube. Now where to put the second tube and where to put the third tube? Okay. So there is a variation. So we call this distance. So suppose center to center distance, we call this as a pitch. Okay. Now this pitch may be from 5 to 12 centimeter. Okay. That means you can take here various ranges. Suppose the for one analysis you can take this as a 5 centimeter. Okay. Then for the next, you can take this as a, suppose the 7 centimeter or 8 centimeter. Then for the third one, you can take this as a 10 centimeter. Okay. And for fourth, you can take this as a 12 centimeter. So now you'll got here four arrangement. That means the pitch values. And with respect to these four pitch values, you can now change the position of these tubes, and you can take the various readings for the temperature and other things. Okay, so these values are there, so it is ranged between 5 to 12, and then after that you can choose the optimum value. Okay, whatever the optimum value which gives you the maximum temperature, you can choose it. Okay, so that is your analysis purpose, that is your for the analysis purpose. Okay, so the pipes are soldered or it may be brazed or welded, or the pressure bounded. Okay, we apply the pressure and then bound it with the absorber plate. Okay, now most commonly used material for this one, I already told you, we are using the copper. Okay, because of its conductivity, so these tubes are generally made up of the copper. Okay, so these are made up of the copper here. Okay, then the next thing, now in the bottom, now here it is given. Now we have to, everything is there. Now we have apply, we have taken the glass cover, we have taken the absorber plate, and we have applied the tubes also. Now we have to insulate all the total system. So we have to use here 2.5 to 8 centimeter thick layer of the glass wool. Okay, so glass wool is used as an insulator in this liquid flat plate collector. Okay, so we are using the glass wool for avoiding any heat transfer outside this flat plate collector. Okay, Now, the most important thing is here the discussions about the glass cover. So the glass cover permits the entry of solar radiation that is transparent from the it only allows the short wavelength which enters into the solar collector, okay, or flat plate collector, okay, and it is opaque for the another types of the infrared radiations, okay, and the other radiations get reflected, and only short wavelength radiations are only allowed to enter inside this flat plate collector. After that, it gets trapped and it will not allow that radiations to go out, okay. So this get reflected here only, okay, and because of that the temperature and these radiations get absorbed by this absorber plate and its temperature get increased, okay. Now we already see this one, the glass cover prevent the heat loss due to the convection by keeping air stacked. So this is the same thing, once the solar radiation get inserted inside this collector, so it doesn't allow that that radiations to go out, okay. So that means that solar radiation or that energy due to that solar radiation, it get trapped in this space, okay, and then they absorb energy and increases. And we know that after that, once the temperature once this absorber plate absorb this energy, then it transfer that heat to the this tube, the which are beneath the absorber plate, okay. So after that, the heat get transferred to the fluid which is flowing through this tube, okay, and the fluid, and this is sufficient to remember, okay. And the what are the components and how the working is very simple. The solar radiation, it is incident on the first, it passes through the glass cover, and the only it will allow the short wavelength radiation that get trapped inside the space between the absorber plate and the glass cover, okay. And after that, the absorber plate, it absorb that the solar radiation, its temperature get increased, and then that heat energy, it is transferred to the fluid which is flowing through the tubes, okay, that is placed below the absorber plate, okay. So likewise, this is the simple working of your liquid flat plate collector. Generally, while designing, some parameters you have to remember. So that is the thickness of the absorber plate, so that is in the range of 0.2 to 1 mm, and the metallic tubes which we are using for transporting the transporting the fluid, so that is in the range of 1 to 1.5 centimeter, okay. And these tubes are generally made up of what, the copper tubes, okay. Now if we see the thermal analysis of this flat plate collector, so this is something that is given in there, okay. So we'll discuss that things also. So that is given here, okay. So everything that is the liquid flat plate collector is given, okay. We'll see that this is in later stage afterward, but we require that thing, Soganti. So here I before going to the thermal analysis of the flat plate collector, so here it is given, see our flat plate collector is mentioned here, okay. And in flat plate collector, so these are some of the that is the the parameters or the technical content that is given on this diagram. So if we see here, first of all we'll see the energy balance. So energy balance of the absorber plate under steady state. So we have already in our previous lecture, we have calculated this value. So that is what, that is our the solar radiations that is incident on the collector, okay. So we have calculated this value, IT value, earlier, okay. Now this S value is what, this S is the incident solar flux absorbed in the collector, okay. This is the incident and this is absorb, okay, S value, okay. Then we have, this is AP means it is the area of the absorber plate, and this is QL is the rate of energy that is lost, okay. So some energy it is lost from this glass cover, while some energy get lost when it comes inside, okay, because of the convection and the radiation, okay. So that is our loss, QL. So this is the total thing, that is the useful heat gain, that is given as AP multiplied by S. So S is the incident solar flux absorbed in the collector, and minus QL means that is the lost. Okay, so this is your main formula. So useful heat gain APS minus QL. Okay, now the heat transfer to the working fluid. Now what is the amount of the after gaining this useful heat gain? So what is the heat get transferred to the to this working fluid? So that is calculated in terms of what, this QU value. Okay, this is QU value. Okay, so that value is what, m dot cf tf0 minus tf0 tfi, that means the fluid inlet temperature and outlet temperature, that is tfi and tf0 tf out. M dot is the mass flow rate energy, and this is m dot is the mass flow rate, and cf is what, specific heat of the fluid. So that is given. Okay, so qu also calculated. So here this is qu is calculated using this formula. So m dot cf tf0 minus tfi. Okay, now we have seen that is the I have calculated in the previous lecture. Just refer the previous videos. So ITV have calculated using this formula, where we have these are the tilt factors IB, that is RB, RR and RD. So these are our the tilt factors. We have calculated this tilt factor using some formulas. So these are the formulas for that tilt factors RB, RD and RR. So these are the our solar geometry angles, delta, phi, beta and other things. Okay, now if you calculate everything, then the final, that is the flux S absorbed on the absorber plate. So that is given in terms of this the final formula, that is S is equal to this formula. Okay, so IB, RB, then this is, now here this is tau alpha. So this tau alpha means this is the this tau means it is the transmittivity, and alpha means it is absorbability. So we will get this parameter in the latter stage, that is the tau alpha B means it is transmittivity absorbability product for beam radiation. And this tau alpha D means it is transmittivity absorbability product for the diffuse radiation. Okay, so that we have to calculate separately for the analysis. Okay, so we'll see that afterwards. So total things what we have done, that is for this factor, that is tau alpha B means it is transmittivity absorbability product for the beam radiation. And if D is there, then it is transmittivity absorbability product for the diffuse radiation. Okay, so this is our thermal analysis for the flat plate collector. Okay, so it is the simple thing, that just the energy balance equations are there, how much energy it is incident on the solar flat plate collector, and how much it is get wasted. So that we have to calculate, we have calculated using the formulas. Okay, so QU, that is our useful heat gain, and that is in terms of, you have written in terms of the absorbing plate area and the incident solar flux absorbed in the collector. Okay, so this is the the thermal analysis of your the flat plate collector. Now before going to the next topic, there are certain the parameters on which the performance of your collector is based. Now these are factor, we already seen the selective surface, that is all. Okay, so you have to consider while taking into consideration. So forms of this collector. Okay, and this parameter, so that is tau alpha B and tau alpha D, so this will get decreases with the increasing number of covers. Okay, so one or two covers are sufficient for this type of the collector. So that is mentioned here. Spacing, so that is also important, the spacing between the two covers and that of two covers, and that between the temperature, between temperature vary with the tilt. Okay, so that you have to consider whenever we are putting the spacing between the two glass cover. So this is also very important. So that spacing also affects your collector. Okay, so spacing between the two covers, so that is also the important parameter for the performance of your collector. Then collector tilt, we have seen these are the non-concentrating type of the collectors, and this is our beta angle, so that is our tilt. So this is one, now this is one time we have to, okay, we can't take the solar tracking of this one, we are not moving this one. So this angle is very important. So this is here beta or pi they have taken. So this collector tilt is one of the important parameter for the performance of your this collector. Then the another most important the parameter is what the dust on top of the cover. Okay, so many times we generally avoid this type of this parameter. We do not consider because during the working or daytime during the working of this collector, the dust get collected on this this collector, and because of that, the efficiency of this collector decrease. Okay, so this the cleaning is required to remove the dust and to get the efficiency of this collector. So again, the dust on the top of the cover is one of the important parameter. If you refer the YouTube channel, so and if you search the removal of the dust on the from the solar panels, okay, so they have made some robots here. So that is the such type of the robot having the rollers at the two ends, and these are having the spray of that water, and they get rolled on this collector, and at the same time they also clean the total panel. Okay, so that type of the instruments are available on the YouTube also. Okay, so that is the another the concept, that is the dust on the top of the cover. So these are such as the collector may be asked in the MCQ question, what are the various parameter on the performance of the collector. So selective surface, which type of observer surface we are selecting, so that is our selective surface. Then number of covers, it is maximum it is one or two. Spacing between these surfaces, there are two covers. Then collector tilt, that is one of the another important the parameter. Okay, so and the last one is on the top of the cover. Okay, so these are the five parameters are there which we have to consider while to get the better performance of our collector. Okay, now this is all regarding with the liquid flat plate collector. Okay, now the on the same ground, okay, on the same ground we will discuss the flat plate air heating collector. Now instead of the fluid, okay, which is flowing inside this one, we have air only. Okay, so in this is our for taking this example, you take this liquid flat plate collector. So this is our solar water heater. So water get heated, so cold water enters into the collector and hot water get out. Now instead of water, just consider the air, so that becomes your solar so the flat plate air heating collector, or it is also called as the solar air heater. Okay, it is solar air heater. Now in solar heater, what will happen? Everything will remain same. The construction is same. That means we have the glazing, that means the glass plate on the top. Then we have the absorber plate. We have the tubes. We have that the tubes are also there. Okay, so tubes are generally for the passage of the air. If you are not placed the tubes also, that is there. Okay, there is no need to place the tube. The tubes are just only for covering the absorber plate. Sometimes this is the one type of arrangement over which the tubes are there and the absorber surface, that means the tubes are used as the absorber surface. They are painted black and they are used as the absorber surface. In air the solar air heater, we don't require the tubes, only this flat surface is sufficient. You painted it black so that it acts as a absorber surface. Okay, then we have insulation and other things. So and from one side we have to force the air, and from here it comes out. So to force the air inside this air collector, we have to use here the blower. Okay, we have to use here the blower. Okay, so here blower is required to force the air inside this solar air collector, and then it comes outside. Okay, now the most important thing regarding the flat plate air collector is what? The heat transfer coefficient between this air. So here we have the air, it is flowing. Okay, this is the entry of the air, and this is the entry of the this is the output of the air. So this is cold air here, so this is, and this is hot air here. What will happen? The air coefficient between air and the absorber plate, the sufficient out of the air. Okay, so to increase this heat transmission between this absorber plate and the air, so we are using here different types of the arrangements. Okay, so this is called as the corrugated surface. Here is a these are the corrugated surface, or we call this as we are called this as a roughness. We call this as a roughness geometries. Roughness geometries. Now, for which purpose we are using these roughness geometries? These roughness geometries will increase. They see the if this is not there. That means if this corrugated surface or these roughness surfaces are not there. So what will happen? The air will go straight. Something like this. The air is something like this straight, and it will not contact the suppose this is our absorber surface, so it will not take the heat from this heated absorber plate. So that's why this the temperature of this output air is very low. So what we have to do now, we have to move the air toward the absorber surface. So for that purpose we are using this type of the arrangement, the roughness geometry. So when the air flows through this one, so the turbulence occurred, the turbulence occurs in the air, and because of that turbulence, the air now it gets in contact with the roughness geometries, and this geometry is what it is heated. It acts as an absorber plate, and maximum amount of heat get absorbed from by the air from this absorber. So that's why we'll get the required the amount of temperature on the output air. Okay, so for this purpose these roughness geometries are used. Okay, and this is the maximum that means the use of this the flat plate collector is what it is used for agriculture purpose, for drying of the agricultural products, and in industrial purposes, and in space also, space heating also. Okay, so these are the general the use of this purpose. Now let me show you. So this is the so this is in PhD topic. So I have worked on this the topic. So effect of the roughness geometries on the heat transfer energy solar thermal system. So I have already told you, we already discussed this, what is meant by this air heater. Okay, so here if you see here, this is the geometries. So this type of geometries are there. Okay, so this one, and now these are the geometries. See, so what is this? This is the pitch. Okay, so that is also there. How much pitch you have to take so that the air flows. So then it must take the contact with the absorber plate and then it get removed. Okay, like this. Okay, so this is the there. So okay, see, this is the type of the absorber plate. Then we have another. So this is the transverse rib, then this is transverse broken rib. So many researchers use different types of the geometries like this. Okay, so this is our inclined ribs with gaps. Okay, then we have, then this is the again that type of the ribs. So this is the V down ribs. Okay, these are the another types of the arrangement. So this is another type of this is called the wedge shaped ribs. Okay, then we are here, this is the rib groove geometry. Okay, then we have chamfered ribs. So these are the chamfered ribs. Okay, and then this is expanded metal mesh, is also one of the type of the rib geometry. Now this one is the another type of the geometry, that is the where the that is the impingement. Okay, or it is called the impingement on the plates, and because of that the roughness will occur. This is W shaped ribs. Okay, so okay, this is diamond shape. Okay, so this is Z shaped ribs. Okay, these are the geometry they are in the mentioned in the previous research. Then this is the what the CFD analysis they have performed on this one. So these are the things. Okay, see, this type of geometries are there. So this is what, this is our geometries, and over this the water is flowing, something like this, air is flowing. Now when the air flows over this roughness geometry, so it create the turbulence because of the the resistance, and when the resistance, that is the turbulence, is created, so there is a maximum contact between the air and the absorber plate. Okay, and once contact increases, so there will be the maximum amount of heat absorbed by the air, and we'll get the required efficiency of the air. So see, this is one type of another geometries. Okay, so these are there. So air flows something like this. Okay, here, and we'll get the respective attachment end of the attachment point. See, these are the types of the geometry. So this is the rectangular, trapezoidal, delta, like this, third. Okay, for the CFD analysis. Okay, so this is flow domain. So the air is flowing something like this, and because of this, let me show you whether I CFD analysis result. So that may be in okay, that may be present here. Let me show you whether I have that geometries. Yeah, here you see this one. See, this is your ribs. Okay, this is later. Now this air is flowing. So see, when it strikes here, so see here the turbulence is creating. We are getting here vortices, and because of this one, so this it comes in contact with this observer plate. So this is our observer plate here. Okay, and when it comes in contact with this one, so there is a rotation. That means this vortex means what? Cold air, it goes up. The top layer only it gets the heats, and then there is a transfer of heat to the bottom layer, but this heat transfer is very low. The another thing is what, to increase the heat transfer, we know that to create the turbulence. So once you create the turbulence, and that is created using what is roughness geometry. So we have to create here the turbulence. So here you see this one. So this is the red area. It shows what the air, that is the air is moving up, and it is taking the heat from this absorber plate, and then it is going in the direction. Okay. So these are the thing, the results. Okay. So these are with respect to pressure and all these things. Okay. This one. Here you can see this one. Okay, here. So if you consider the same thing, so this is the blue area. That means here there is no transfer of heat. And if you refer this area, the roughness geometry, so here see there is an increase of the temperature, and finally we get the required amount of the heat transfer at the outlet end. So this is all regarding the today's lecture. So we have discussed today the liquid flat plate collectors and the air heating collector. Okay, so I hope you understand the thermal analysis. We'll take in details again in the third lecture, in the third unit. Okay, and in next lecture we'll now the evacuated flat plate collectors. Okay, so for today's lecture, then we will stop here. Okay, so if you have any questions regarding today's lecture,